Navi. We're going to see how he's going to fare here on train, considering they're starting on T-side Navi. So I guess one thing is you can say is that Navi will get to set the pace, but I think very early on we're going to see what they're capable of here, if they're going to be able to get their heads fresh after that first map, that grueling overtime map.
Already, it's interesting. Two Molotovs and a smoke. Fallen has a smoke as well. If you're used to watching Counter-Strike, you already know what's on my mind. It's the idea of planting B and just keeping the fire burning on it. The tag showing they're not welcome on the ramp, but Coldzera has already gone down. Taco left cowering back into the bombsite, just has to run, try and stay alive. What a flick to take down Simple, but I'm not sure it's enough. Edward, again with the pistol, he's such a beast, jumping up on the train, following through on the smoke, he nearly gets the triple. Now it's a 2-on-3, Fur and Phelps. Can they possibly retake this? There's still that Molotov, and they don't have the smoke currently picked up. That one Molotov can ruin this whole round for SK. What are they doing?
Yeah, what are they doing? Are they expecting some kind of flank? They don't have all the info, obviously. Seized. He's going to throw that Molotov now, pretty much, and that's gonna snuff this round. Phelps has found the kit. They have that to go with, at least. And Fur looking for the fight, but he's not going to get it. Guardian, another kill for him. That's two. Can he make it three? Because Phelps is battling with them, but Phelps is roasting alive.
No chance at all. He taps the bomb once. He gets the headshot, but there isn't enough time. He knows it. Pure surrender coming out of Phelps here. The plan worked more or less to perfection. The fact that they got the first frag on upper there meant they only had to worry about Taco. What a round from Na'Vi. And this, I think, is critical. We've talked about this so many times, but they come out swinging like that after the triple overtime. Mm-hmm. Great sign.
Yeah, absolutely. Now I'm looking for a match here. This is going to be good. Three rifles, two UMPs for Na'Vi. They aren't messing around either. Not going to skimp in any way. And a good nade count. But once again, it is a little bit of a slower pace, but they could be set up for a split onto A here. The bomb in main, seized, getting set up for the flash, and Edward going to win the duel versus Phelps.
How did she not just go down? Taco will follow up, so they just could not escape the mag 7 at the end. Seized and Guardian 2-on-4. This round has fallen apart, and Coldzera, there's the Deagle headshot. Triple kill for him at the moment. Just looking for the last one of the quad here. Seized will go down to Fallen instead. So SK bring it right back. Aggressive positioning with the mag 7 and the Coldzera with the triple kill.
Unbelievable. Cold more than makes up for his performance in the pistol. This is sick work from him. And as soon as Guardian is pinned down with that bomb, it is so difficult for Na'Vi to fight their way out, especially after having committed all the utility to actually getting out onto the site. What a round from Cold. He just made the difference for his team. And now, do we get to see the trademark CT side from SK Gaming, where it's just the lockdown. Phelps gets the first, gets the second. They aren't able to trade. Simple, he's going to be fuming.
Always dangerous to follow more people down that ladder. We've definitely seen people pick up both triples and quads when you just go down one at a time with no flashbangs or anything. Shame, because if they had got pop dog control, they would have been able to sandwich onto the bomb site and get the bomb down based on this wall of smokes that's about to land right here at A. Now they're just coming in from one angle, and I just doubt it'll work.
Good comms. Good comms, though. Doesn't mean that SK over-rotated towards B. In fact, they're going to have four players here. Can they deny the bomb plant? Yes, they can. Fur just there in the nick of time. Great communication there from SK Gaming. You can see the thought process there where they were thinking, okay, do I need to rotate over towards B? Is this the time? But as soon as you count how many smokes are actually coming in, even in the air, you're seeing three nades? Right, okay, we know where they are. This is what's going to happen. And a very quick reaction there from SK Gaming, really giving Na'Vi nothing to work with in that round.
No bomb plant, no money. Not that they could have bought anything, but it will obviously help them in the upcoming round. AWP really early on Fallen here. And he tends to play over by that Ivy position, and he's so good at playing that one. And he's got Cold already actually going to be checking towards T-spawn, so he knows no one is on that side of the map. Phelps is realizing that's because they're all here. Still picks up two quick kills, Taco there in the back, and also with the flashbang in, Edward finding a hard time returning the frags when he can't see anything.
Do not risk that AK, Taco. It is time to back off. Fur, though, might get caught here. Does get the shot onto Edward. He was so very low on HP, and he's going for the hero knife. You gotta try everything, Anders. You gotta try. Can't fault him for that.
It would have been good.
But that's some aggression right there. Not going to work, though. But that is some aggressive play. And it's aggressive play on all fronts, really. Do you really want to go close quarters when you know that Na'Vi are going to be on pistols in the round? You're pushing Brown Halls, Cold pushing Alley. He could have walked right into two people, and they could have gunned him down and picked up his gun, his rifle. So, I mean, risks being taken here by SK Gaming. But they're just trying to pummel Na'Vi right now, trying to put as much mental pressure as possible on the on the mix, the CIS mix team. Can't really say Ukrainian anymore.
No, they're a bit all over the place, aren't they? Taco gonna go over an early grenade. Doesn't really do that much. And Na'Vi could not afford the AWP. Because they didn't get the bomb plants down in time, they were lacking the money. Probably would have been glass cannon anyway for Guardian, but I think it would have been worth it. Edward trying to see if he could click far away, and that's going to be very successful. That leaves alone on the bomb site Taco, and he's needs some backup quick. He's actually going to go before his teammates show up, and that might have been a mistake. Now SKF got to fall back. There's no chance.
That snuffs the round right there. But what cool work coming in from Edward. Just calmly tapping far away. The boost, clever stuff, but unfortunately Cold loses his teammate. Fallen is gone. Bit of a dive there. Quick thinking from Cold to save that AWP and start backing off, but Na'Vi are already out hunting. Phelps has got a decent spot where they'll have to come at him one at a time. And Cold on the other side of the map. Now the question is whether they can actually save these guns.
Oh,
and
no.
Phelps is doubting himself. He's going to go back into the open. This is not going to work out for him. Somehow he makes it. How does he get the second kill unseized?
It looked like the timing was the worst possible, but somehow he still lives, and Cold will too with the AWP. So making the most out of a terrible situation there is SK. Still 3-2 the scoreline. And yeah, Edward just getting out on upper that quick. And because Taco's holding down on the low ground, he can't really help out. So as soon as he's alone on the bomb site, I think that's the main problem, is that he sort of panicked a bit and went for that fight before his teammates in the C connector were there. And once Taco's down, they can't even get into the bomb site anymore.
Yeah, it's over. He is the linchpin at that point. That's also a failure on Fur's part, not winning the duel versus Edward. Hardly doing any damage at all to Edward. But hey, more aggression. That's the key. Cold, this time with the AWP, the easiest shot of his life on Edward. There will be no star performance from Edward this round. They're looking to try and follow up on this very quickly, however, Na'Vi. Pushing all the way down the ramp, and that's going to cost him further to take down Seized. And Taco with that HE does tremendous damage, follows it up with some bullets too, why not?
Spray down the transfer right in the face of Simple. Very well done. Taco, that's about time. He ends up playing predictably in that position where he's sort of playing close, then he falls back to the same train every time. Must be very careful, but this time he certainly switched it up. It is a very good transfer here.
That's clean work. Flamey is going to be fuming because that's his usual spot. He loves to play from that angle, and you can see it turns it into a headshot angle. Very difficult for Na'Vi, whereas Taco obviously has their whole body to shoot at. He can just spray and pray. Solid work. HE just peppering Flamey, not too much there. But an eco round now for Na'Vi going into the seventh. It's a 4-2 round. And Cold, once again, aggro. I love it. Going brown halls like that early.
This definitely presents a new challenge for Na'Vi, because before they only had to worry about falling over at Ivy with the AWP. Now there's Cold Zero on the other side of the map. That means they have to use a lot more tools. nice one deke from Flamey. But yeah, they've got to use more tools now to make sure those AWPs can't just get free reign. You've got to put down smokes and molotovs early, and then you don't have them later potentially. So curious about how they're going to deal with that.
This has got to be so deflating for Na'Vi. You win the pistol, you're thinking, great, this is it. You clutch it no less. I mean, it was... That's how you get fired up. And then to lose in the following round, now your life has basically become a nightmare. The double HE towards main, they mess one up, but Phelps, again, very quickly into Pop Dog. I don't know, this is a bit much for Taco, really. Two rounds in a row for Cold going for the peak there. Glad that he showed some restraint and he didn't commit, because Na'Vi were definitely ready to punish anybody peaking there.
It's really weird. I think Cole was all the way over by on the A side. Fallen going to pick up the shot as well. That's just... I don't know why they would put both the AWPs down Ivy, but they did. Cold finding a second kill as he rotates back to the A-bomb site. So now it's Simple and Guardian left. 2 versus 5. And this is the fear that anyone on the Na'Vi side would have had going into this game. This CT side from SK is so hard to break. In the beginning, they didn't quite have the utility or all the rifles to deal with it. Now they've had a couple of really good rounds, and the money is quite frankly out of control for SK. They have all but one got plus $10,000 in the bank.
And this is what maybe is going on here. Edward doing a lot of talking. Starks and Seized not looking too happy. And they need to, I mean, this is almost where I want to see like a throwback to old Existence days, right? Before there were timeouts in CS, if you had an hard eco, Existence, the Belgium leader, he would actually use hard ecos like this as timeouts. Just jump around and T-spawn, run the clock down and talk the round over. But now with only 1 2-minute timeout, you know that Na'Vi would want to call a timeout right now. They're just trying to save it until later.
Wallbang coming out there. You could see Phelps.
Please, teammate.
A bit aggressive. Fur actually goes down. It's not bad. Again, any damage, any rifles that could be stolen, any little inch here. Now we don't need a huge amount of rounds on the first half. Just even 5 would do. They would stay competitive in the map. So they just need to think about how to grind some of those rounds out. The fact that they've already have 2 rounds is not that bad at all. And they're simple. Taking down Colt Sierra. 2-on-3. And there's Edward with another headshot. Simple will be going down. Otherwise, they maybe could have sandwiched Fallen in. But now Edward's going to go down. Just lack of armor. Ends up losing him his life. That was a round that was much closer than it needed to be.
Jeez, the money that SK have, though. Unreal. This has been going so well. They've been keeping players alive. 2 guys fully bought up. 3, in fact, above $10,000 still in the bank. The other 2, $8,500, $6,700 on Ferret. I mean, that's ridiculous. SK have very little to worry about at this point. They lose a round, they'll bounce right back. Fallen looking to buy a little bit of time with the flash, and he's got that angle once again on Ali. Where is Cold on the map? He doesn't have an op this round.
This is so aggressive from Taco. Grenade, and then he tries to run up behind it. If they had been spraying through the smoke, then he would have run right into it. Now Na'Vi, again, slowing it down. What can they come up with? It seems like right now what they're doing is simply setting up all across the map and waiting to see if SK will go aggressive anywhere. And that's going to be fine for the next 40 or so seconds, but after that, they need to make up their minds.
They're doing a very good job of managing their nade economy, though, Na'Vi. Have to give them that. 5 smokes still in play. They had 3 Molotovs. Edward just threw one out. I mean, they're doing a very good job of saving up, and when it is going to come down to the B execute, they'll have everything they need. But 3 players are here right now for SK Gaming. With Cold Zera already in Pop Dog, very quick rotate is possible here.
This won't be an easy side to take at all. They have no idea right now, Na'Vi. They have no information to indicate that there's going to be this many people waiting. Fur hiding in the corner. The quick trade there. Edward for Cold Sierra. Fur still waiting by the ladder. He's going to be crouching right in. Actually falls back down. He gets the headshot. Takes down Flamey. Dropping the bomb. Turning around. The 180 spray. And Fur with a quick double. 25 seconds here. And Seized is charging in with a knife out. He pretty much has to. If he wants to try and win this 1v2, it's going to be full speed. Jumping down the ramp and making quite a bit of noise. And on the other side, Fur going to close the round out. Triple for him. No one even doing any damage at all.
I wish that we had Simple's perspective, though. Did you see that? He had 2 kills before Fur could go for the 180 and get rid of him. What was happening there? How did Simple get those 2? But Guardian, you have to give it to Guardian. Committing 2 players to Pop Dog that late in the round from Na'Vi. You can see that SK, they had the 2 additional players on B. They were starting to rotate towards A, and that's where Simple gets the kills. Taco and Phelps. Cotton connector. Confusing, very tight round there, but still able to make it work. 8-2, and Cold aggro. 3 players here. This could be big. He's going to charge it right behind him. There's the one. He drops the bomb carrier.
He doesn't realize there's another guy behind him, so C's going to be walking in. UMP in hand and Cold. Must be feeling pretty safe at the moment from this angle. Seized. Almost missing the opportunity there. He at least gets the 1 kill, but now they're all right on the other side waiting for him. And with that grenade, they know exactly where he is, so he's completely trapped. He can't even fall back into T-spawn either. And that will be the round. Fallen with a triple. SK 9-2. If you, I mean, the scoreboard here, it's just become sort of a wall of blue. 6 rounds in a row here for SK Gaming. This is what everyone was worried about.
And there it is, the timeout. Seize decides enough is enough. We need to slow things down. Every single time that Cold is going aggro right now, he's finding a target. He's finding a pick. This is getting wild. And yeah, we do have Simple's perspective. Awesome. There's one. That was like the longest fight, actually. He was out there for ages.
Yeah, the fact that he gets the headshot on Phelps is ridiculous. Speaking of Phelps, just because we were talking about whether or not, you know, they would be better or worse or roughly the same on playing on this map with a new player, they've got 13 kills on Phelps alone. He's actually top fragging in the server, so he's definitely not suffering at all from playing on train.
But again, look at this, Anders. They're all like, this is when you know It's very scary. And Na'Vi had this quality in the first half, in Mirage as well, in the first half going into the second half, where it was everybody within 2 to 3 kills of each other across the board. There wasn't just this one hard carry. It's flipped. SK Gaming, you got Phelps at the top with 13, but then Taco is last with 8. Everybody else is in between. Whereas Flamey has got one single kill, Anders.
Yeah, not enough. They obviously need every single player. I mean, they had everybody playing when they were on Mirage, and still they lost eventually. So if one or two players here is out, I think Seas is also struggling, then you can tell what's happening here. SK are very quickly moving towards the semifinals. Man, it would be very interesting to see what would happen between North and SK.
Absolutely. There is a level of parity there when it comes to aim and firepower. Config and Magisk going toe-to-toe with Cold. And well, I mean, whoever, at this point, I mean, Farrah has already given us a star performance today. We can see Farrah, we can see Cold, we can see Fallen, even Vako.
Ready and waiting. 10 seconds left in the timeout here. Na'Vi are about to go into a round where they've got plenty of grenades. They've got the AWP on Guardian. Those are really good signs. The UMP on Simple, I don't think it's enough to really worry about. I think the main problem is still just them getting onto the bomb sites. They're not even losing the afterplants here. They're just not even being allowed onto the sites. Here it is.
Yeah, if you do look, ow.
12th round is coming in. The bomb dropped far back. Na'Vi still just looking for an early frag on anyone that they can. Cold showing himself over at top B. And that slows Na'Vi down again. Just the fact that he's there for a quick peek means they have to be a bit worried.
This has been so dominant, Anders. In the 9th and 10th round, SK Gaming survived with 2 players. That is the lowest they've been. Otherwise, all the other rounds are 4 players with a couple of 3s mixed in. That's unreal. SK are just so dominant on this map when it comes to their CT side. 9-2, Fallen attempts the shot, but he's smart. He's gonna be able to fall back from that position. Very clever stuff, doesn't overcommit.
And on the other side, no reason, I think, why they're shooting through this smoke right now. Very dangerous if you end up losing that battle. Taco will be going down to Guardian, so that is finally a good start here for Na'Vi. 50 seconds, can they build anything based on this? Look at how many people are stacked on the A side here. Even Cold Zero, who's kind of looking into B, can be at the A bomb side in a couple of seconds. So Na'Vi, with a man lead, probably feel like, look, they can't surely all be in A bomb side, but the fact is they can. And that smoke going up at 30 seconds left in main means how are they going to make their way through? SK have such a good read on this round, it's kind of scary. Phelps will be going down at least. A Simple picking up that kill for, takes down one. The bomb trying to make its way through on Edward, and he gets that very important kill. Otherwise, they would have had to try and retrieve the bomb. Sees it down next, 2-on-3. This should be Na'Vi's round. It's all looking perfect at the moment. And Fallen, he can't stop the bomb from going down, but he gets the kill on Edward right after. Goes for a second one, taking down Flamey, and now Simple, 1 versus 2. Suddenly, it turns against them, and he tries to get the sprays, hiding behind the electric box here. So much time still left on that bomb. Very, very hard for him to stay alive here.
Both have kits on SK as well, so there is time to work with. There's the peek. Simple plays the angle, but Cold hits the shot. And Simple, that's so difficult. He did everything right. He gets that 1v1 duel. He just happens to run into the one man with the AWP, and Cold doesn't miss. And what looked like such a strong start. Here's the Fallen that was missing from SK on Mirage. The high impact kills coming in, making the difference for his team when they need him. He's not falling behind this time around. He's at 12 kills right behind Phelps.
Again, devastating for Na'Vi. They get the entry. They go for a very good attack onto the A-bomb site. The whole SK team is just waiting for them. Ultimately, that is also what contributed to that round for the Brazilian side. And again, very heavy stack on the A-bomb site.
Yeah, 10-2. This is it. Cold there with the opening kill. Phelps, even falling, finds a headshot on Edward. Cold Zera, a second kill for him. Na'Vi, they aren't able to trade effectively. They don't have anything going their way. Seized on 40 HP in a 1v3 now. At least he has the bomb. But what do you really hope to do? Because they can leave 2 players on A and just rotate a man connector on B to keep an eye on things there.
I think they just saw where he was. Phelps up on that train, definitely realizing he can play a deep mind game. He doesn't have to stay in main. Fallen back, and he does actually get tagged up. So not an easy life right now for Seized. That's that one, the last round where they got the bomb, that is the only bomb plant they've had yet. Every other round has been all kills for SK Gaming.
Just silly.
Yeah, that says something about the magnitude of the defense here for the Brazilian side. 40 seconds left. Seized would love it if someone would go and fight him.
35 seconds left. They are thinking that he did go B, though. But still, superior numbers should mean that SK will prevail. This is all down to Seized hitting his shot when the time comes. 20 seconds left. He's leaving himself so little room for error now. There's a man in Pop Dog as well, and Phelps peaks at just the right time. Nothing Seized could do. 11-2. Another big round picked up for SK Gaming.
Absolutely amazing. It is so fun to see just how good they are still at this map, and you have to wonder what happens if they get into the finals, even the semifinals against North. Is it going to be a sort of a thing where people just try and avoid this map once again against them? Because that happened for a while, where people just started banning it every single time. We know obviously North are not going to be playing Train anyway, but 14th round is in, and this time, can they make it work, Na'Vi? They need the last two rounds, absolutely do.
Well, Taco's got he's got his guard 20, so why not? Playing retake B right now, SK Gaming. They're figuring that Na'Vi are just going to keep committing to A, and that certainly is the case. Phelps is still in connector, so he can back them up. They haven't seen anything yet, SK Gaming. They're still waiting to see where Na'Vi are going to show their hand. Fur finds a headshot on Simple. We don't even see it, but sees now. He's got an angle. Can he find a shot? No, he gets surprised. Fallen and Fur ruin his day.
Now Fallen just charging in with the AWP. He doesn't even care. It's Phelps picking up another two kills, leaving Guardian alone. No scope, not quite connecting. Trying a bit too hard there is Fallen. Guardian will eventually go down. There's no chance at all. They also have that auto sniper in play for Taco. Phelps right now, 18 kills in 14 rounds. That is definitely not bad. And still, Flamey is stuck at one. Caesar's got three kills. The rest of Na'Vi are at least trying, but those two players right now are not having a fun game. That's 15 rounds in. We're just starting at the 15th here. And SK are looking like, you know, after they broke it in that triple overtime, they were ready to take it on Train for sure.
Cajun is going to have to give Flamey a hug after this. You know, he knows how it feels to have such a horrible performance. When it's all on the line, this is painful. Phelps going for the peak. He's going to get it. There's Edward. Oh, no! The headshot point blank. And then, well, man advantage now for SK Gaming.
With the UMP as well. That must be even worse if you're on the Na'Vi side. Guardian hoping that someone will be hiding close in that corner for sneaking and catching Seized. And that should just spread panic at the Na'Vi lineup. Now, they have no idea if Fur has moved up, if he's continuing to push in behind them. They could be locked in at the moment. I mean, we can tell that he hasn't. But for Na'Vi, this is just a very uncomfortable position to be in.
This is very good to counter, exactly. Excellent work there. Positioning from Guardian. He gets a key frag on Taco. Simple will find Phelps as well. So it's a 3-on-3, just like that.
Oh, Fallen. He had the pre-fire. He gets the kill on Simple as well. The bomb is down and Fallen comes through. 3 in a row. Almost effortless. That will make it 13-12. SK Gaming. 3 rounds away from making another semi-finals after having added Phelps to the mix. They still look like a world-class team.
Oh, they look stronger than ever. It's not that they looked weak with Fox either. It's almost like the team just kept operating at such a high level.
Come on.
But yeah, Fallen, this is just all fun and games for him at this point. Clear difference between Mirage, right? He needs to put more work into Mirage to figure out how he can get comfortable to the level he is here on Train, because on Train, he's just doing work. 15 kills for him. You got to give it to Phelps, though. This additional firepower from him, 19 kills at the end of the first half on Phelps. That's a monster performance.
How can Na'Vi get back in this game? I mean, for one thing, they need Seized and Flamey. I think we've had a couple of games in the past, especially on big stages, where Flamey sort of mentally almost has like the lights just go out, where he gets really stressed. You know, he was playing so good on the first map, but you can kind of tell that this is getting to him now.
All or nothing now. 13-2. Na'Vi won the pistol in the first half as well. That, you know, just let that sink in. Na'Vi won the pistol, and they still only have 2 rounds going into the second half. Are SK Gaming going to be able to pick up the T-side pistol for themselves as well and really just put an end to it here. We've already had two 16-2s so far. Are we going to get another one here, Anders?
USPs all around nearly for the Na'Vi side. SK with a much more traditional buy. No fancy Molotovs or anything else like that. Just a single smoke there on Fallen. Edward being quite aggressive. He sees the feet of Cold Sierra, but he can't really get that headshot in. Not enough showing. So just a quick little bump over at the hallways.
Quick correction. We've had three 16-2s. Sorry. Just need to... All right.
Look at how aggressive they're being over in Brown Halls right now. Both Edward and Flamey are there. There's Edward finding Cold Sierra after the first little peek. They finally managed to fight. The Guardian spots out Tarko's over by Ivy. Edward ending up with two quick headshots, taking out Phelps and Fur. And now I don't see how SK can win this round. They have the time, but just two versus five at the moment. Fallen trying to get that kill, but C's showing up. And Tarko battling long range. He gets a good couple of kills in, but that was never going to happen. So Na'Vi pick up the pistol. Slow start here, but they needed that.
What they need now is to figure out what they can do for rifle rounds. You just saw it there with the pistol stats. I mean, they were at 10, now 11 pistol round wins so far this tournament. That's an obscene statistic. And so how is it that you're able to get these pistol rounds? You should be giving yourself every advantage. And yet when it comes to the rifle rounds, it's just not working for you. At least they give themselves a chance here. 13-3, 10 round lead for SK. And a force buy for SK, although, yeah, I know Fallen did actually spend all of his money. Thought that he might try and manage it a little bit, but it's not the case. They're committed here, SK.
I would be careful and stay out of the range of this scout. No reason to give him any kind of opening, especially even if he just hits the body shot, because they've got the deagles in play as well. And there's Cold Sierra, headshot on Edward. Surely not again, Na'Vi. This happened in the first half as well, when they won the pistol and then second round got stolen away. They've got to make sure that doesn't happen one more time. And SK is so comfortable. They're just slowly creeping out, but they got the bomb back there. So wherever the opening presents itself, they're going to be ready. And Cold Sierra, look how far he needs. He sees the feet, but Guardian shows up just in time. And Phelps goes down next. Fallen gets a headshot with the scout, but it might be too late here.
However, he can be close quarters, and they're not going to expect him to be this close. Seized, though, prepared for it somehow. Now Fur's got a FAMAS. Not going to work any better. Seized gets the headshot with the USP, and Simple will find Tarko. And so they do survive. What didn't work for them in the first half, here they are successful. Two rounds back-to-back for Na'Vi, doubling their round score, Anders. Let's go. You got to start somewhere.
Man. And the problem is, because they lose so many rifles, you know, Na'Vi need to have everything. This has to be, you know, the double AWP or the AWP auto sniper with all the Molotovs and everything. They've got to be in a really comfortable position. SK not quite keeping up the pressure in this round. There's no reason why they would anyway. Seized around the corner there with the MP9. Going to do a pretty good job taking a couple of kills. And following up is Edward coming out of Pop Dog. So, yeah, this is sort of round that Na'Vi really need.
Yep, just put the SMGs in close quarters. Firth, however, will find a kill with an MP9, no less. Bonus $600 in his pocket, so he'll be pleased about that going into the next round. And we're in a 2-on-3, but still a far cry away from a successful round for SK Gaming. They could do better if they could find another kill, actually force Na'Vi to drop one of those rifles. Then we're talking some serious damage. But right now, Na'Vi shouldn't be too worried about the situation. SK gathered up in Pop Dog, it looks like. Brown Halls.
Na'Vi also have a choice to make. You can tell that Flamey and Guardian, actually all of them are far enough away that they're sort of prepared for the idea that maybe SK can get in and get the bomb plant down. But the problem is, if you fight to prevent that, you could also end up losing the round completely. So now they're getting a bit closer. Still with 40 seconds left. This is not without an element of risk for Na'Vi being this close. Simple, right at the edge of the smoke, gonna take both of them down. No problem there with the UMP. But again, if you're holding that close to the actual site, if you end up going down, no one's going to be able to stop the bomb plant, and suddenly it's a 2-on-2. 13-5, though. And now they only lose the two members. Now, straight double AWP for them. No hesitation. Seized with the one, Guardian with the other, and obviously Fallen has one on the SK side, too. They are so far behind in this game now, but it's still very hard to imagine they really can come back. We're going to have to see it to believe it.
I love this call from Seized, though. Nobody even on B early on. In case SK really wanted to go for the pressure play, just go for the straight rush onto A site. Seized decided to rally all of his troops in the same position. That's not going to help Simple, though. And Taco Infer, two big kills to open up the A site. Guardian and Flamey still alive, however, Seized. Going to find an angle to work with. No, Flamey's only going to get the one.
Guardian and Seized, they need to bring this back. Look how low all of SK are, but there's both the orbs left, so the health doesn't even really matter. Cold Sierra, he goes down. Seized has traded places in the smoke. He can't see a thing. And Fur gets a kill. Taco with a double as well. 14-5 SK Gaming, one step closer to that semi-final. And it was an A attack, and they had the four-man stack. But those two entries, how do you come back from that?
And it's just those two entries are the guys who are on the right side of the smoke for Na'Vi. Because then what does Guardian do? He's over by Ali. He's been smoked out. So he's not going to be able to actually get in there and trade any of these kills. Everything worked perfectly for SK Gaming, despite Na'Vi having the manpower there. A classic smoke for SK here. Between the two trains, going to give Taco some room to work with. Changing it up, instead of going through the smoke, he's actually going to look for the flank, and he is going to find the angle on Flamey. Cold robbing him of the kill, but that's the key frag right there. Taco taking down Guardian from high.
Na'Vi are being overrun here. SK, they can feel it coming. Simple trying for the spray, but he misses it. Cold Sierra with the acrobatics in between the trains. He finally gets dropped. Seized, trying to follow it up, but Fur is there to knock him out. 15-5. Match and map point here for SK Gaming.
Yeah, it seems like we've reached the breaking point. 15-5, all out aggression. Why not from SK Gaming? Get in there, take the fight. Well played from Cole, and another no scope. It feels like no scopes now. I mean, the players, it's a joy to watch Magus go for spray. Like, his spray control is unreal. But now it just feels like these oppers as well, when it comes to no scopes, like, they're just getting so dialed in. Fallen, Cold, Simple, doesn't matter. Even Guardian.
Seized a bit aggressive over at the brown holes. This is so rough. I hope you could hear the SK audience in the background, the fans down there. They obviously want their team to make another semi here. Fur, patience. He takes down Simple. Flamey going to be dropping flops. A bit of a return at least, but Guardian out here with the dual elites, not exactly an encouraging sight. He still tries to take down Fur, and somehow he's going to win the battle again. Taco standing for a moment in the fire, but they still make it a 2-on-2. The bomb is quite far back, and this is just a strange round from both teams.
Oh, this is big, though. Guardian was close enough to hear them stomping around in White Halls. And so, clearly, Flamey rotates over to B. Guardian is not going to be able to catch him coming back to A, but he is going to be very quick on the flank. This is going to get interesting. Guardian, is this going to work? Yes, he finds a key frag. Taco is down. That's the bomb dropped as well. And now you can see Cold. He has no time to play with. He's got 35 seconds left to find Guardian. And Guardian hears him coming from a mile away. Wow, insult to injury.
Cold, he's just going to challenge it. He just doesn't even care. He knows that if he waits around too long, it's not going to matter anyway. Tries to go for it. Quick Guardian up on the container. And that's a very good job. And he does it with the dualies as well. Very interesting. 15-6. If they want to play more overtimes, which, by the way, would be the fourth overtime in the series overall, they need to win 9 rounds in a row here, Na'Vi. No mistakes can be made. It's possible. I mean, that's what SK Gaming actually managed to do in their first half.
Yeah, both going 10-5, 10-5 on Mirage, on T-side. Here, Na'Vi, they have the firepower necessary to set up the same kind of defense. And I love this from SK Gaming, though. SK, you know, they're not going for the force buy. They're not going to draw it out. Instead, they invest slightly in the round, but they will have the money. This is still an eco for SK Gaming. Somehow Steez gets out of there intact. I have no idea.
Guardian with the attempted flashbang. Obviously a bit of a smile on my face, but he did do it a bit too far up. Seized waiting in the corner, and because he was already low, he's going to be going down to Taco. So a chance for a bomb plant here. Fallen is running in behind with it. He's quite far away at the moment, but maybe the rest of SK can buy enough time. Phelps ready for Guardian. He's going to be shut down. Oh no. 3-on-3. The bomb now making its way out Pop Dog towards the A side of the map, and they've got the kill on Flamey too. Na'Vi, how is this falling apart for them? They had everything going on. Simple going to get the kill on Phelps long range, but now because Edward is so low, if he even gets tagged once by this Tech Nine, suddenly Simple will be alone, and Simple shows up instead for the kill on Fur, all on Fallen.
Can Fallen make it out onto the site in time, though?
There it is. That's the shot, and he's not going to get it. Now the best case scenario, exactly. Get the bomb plant, guarantee the money. Well played on Fallen. Now this is still considered, like, air quotes, a win for Fallen. If he can get more out of it, though, that would be big. Not going to hit the shot. 3, 4, and nothing working for him. Simple will eventually hunt him down, and Simple had one hell of a round. 4 kills for Simple. And this will be a 7th round now for Na'Vi, but look at how much damage they do. Even with a half by SK Gaming, they're keeping it so close. Now you know in the next round they're going to have so much money. They have enough for a full buy. No AWP for Fallen unless he wants to go Glass Cannon, but that would be a bit surprising on T-side.
Yeah, don't see any need to. They've been so good at getting the better fights out in that A yard. Actually, will go for it.
Why not?
But yeah, I think they might as well have just gone fast A. I feel like it's been working out brilliantly so far. 23rd round here. Na'Vi trying their best to hang on, but you can tell that they've lost a lot of confidence from that first map here. They're not really feeling it on train at the moment. Oh, and SK, they're going to be quick down the ramp. Look at this. They're not even wasting any time. Flamey, he's going to be close line. They're just coming around the corner. He had no warning, no grenades to signify that there was going to be that kind of a push coming. And now, Fur going to get the bomb down in a 4-on-4. This is a brilliant move from SK. And the grenades out landing on Seized. It's going to be Fallen to finish him off with the AWP. 3 more kills, and it'll be 1 more semifinals for this legendary team. Guardian, just a bit hesitant here. They're going to lose Edward as well. Simple and Guardian are left, and Simple gets a great headshot in, but I'm not sure it's in time. Oh, Guardian taking down Cold Sierra too. And Fallen going to smoke off just to buy the time. He knows that all the pressure now is going to be on Na'Vi. He's got the angle. He's got the flick. He takes one down and close range. One-on-one with the AWP. Fallen to get the kill. And that will be it. 16-7. SK make another semifinals here. And this time at DreamHack Masters Las Vegas. Incredible play from them.
And what a feel-good moment for SK Gaming. The last Masters, they got upset. They were knocked out in the groups here into the playoffs. Once again, a top four finish. And Na'Vi, what a bitter pill to swallow. After your performance on Mirage, you can see the score 25-22. Yeah. You're still not able to make it happen on train. You're still not able to get a top four finish here.
That probably was I think everyone saw that coming, that they needed to win Mirage, because train was probably going to be a very good map for SK, and that's how it ended up. Tough day for Na'Vi. But again, I think they played better than I was expecting, actually, in this quarterfinals. My fear was that it was going to be even more of a brutal beat up. So maybe a hope for this team after all.
Mm. No, the SK, they just continue to impress with the stand-in. They make the semifinals at the Major. Great. Still so dangerous. Here, now that they're a full roster, they've had some time to work together as well. They continue to show this winning mentality. Yeah. Teams would have cracked Mirage with that kind of scoreline.
Yeah, probably would have, right? And just the origin of that kind of mentality, we do have it on stage with Smix, it's Fallen.
Thank you very much, Anders. Congratulations, Fallen, with this top four finish. This is your 10th semifinal in a row, and of course, the first with Phelps. So what are your initial thoughts?
Hello, everyone. It feels awesome to accomplish something like that. I think, as I said, 10 times in a row at semifinals is something to be proud of. We're not satisfied yet. We need to win more trophies. We know we have the potential. We put enough hard work to accomplish it. So for us, we're going to try our best to win this tournament.
Now, the score for this was a 2-0, but of course that first map was so intense. Such back and forth action, it went to triple overtime. So why do you think the map went as long as it did? And in the end, how was SK able to win?
We used to call this matchup as El Clasico, because when we play Na'Vi, it's always like this. It's all heartbreaking. We have a lot of matches against in the past that went just like this. And those guys are just too good. They're just super good. They can adapt fast. They have a lot of strat books where they can use a lot of things to play. So it's very difficult to play against, and no matter the score, I'm probably beaten.
Well, I know that this event was the first test for Phelps, but there are other teams that are testing out new players, one of which is North, which is the team that you're going to be playing in the semifinal. They're looking really solid as well with the addition of AZ, so what do you think about that matchup?
Yeah, I think playing North is always very difficult. They're a good team as well. Both teams, as you said, have new players. It's up to who is more adapted and fastly, up to the practice and stuff like this. Let's see. It's going to be a good battle. We're going to try to study a little our opponents, try to figure out which maps they want to play, and we'll make sure that we're going to be ready for tomorrow.
Congratulations, Fallen. Amazing as always. And with that, SK will be our fourth team to move on to the semifinal.
Smix there with Fallen, getting a good grip of exactly how confident Fallen is going into his semi-final versus North. But the reason he got there was the 2-0 we did just witness versus Na'Vi. Still, Machine here with Duncan Thorin Shields, Jason Moses O'Toole, and Yanko YNK Punovic. Just to wrap up your day, not only summarizing this game, but the day as a whole. I'm going to open with you, Yanko, because I think we just witnessed what we kind of described on the desk. We set the scene by suggesting that Na'Vi were going to have the capability to push SK to make them sweat, and indeed they did on Mirage. Train a different story, but I think we should start on that first map, which was kind of more of an indication
first
of why
two maps,
we saw
really.
Sorry?
First two maps. It was long.
That's what I was getting at. Let's move on.
It was sort
Listen,
of like...
they don't all
It was sort of like if they'd had two maps, but it was one map, actually.
Yeah, so. Oh, because it was an overtime. Okay.
It was very reminiscent of the MLG Columbus Grand Final, as Jason pointed out in the green room as well, because you have an extremely close first map, Mirage, as it was the case back then. And then because of that, because of the close loss, Na'Vi just really deflates for the second map and it doesn't really arrive on the server at all. So that's rather unfortunate, but you could see that the both maps were a lot of weird CS in a sense that it was very scattered. A lot of players going for individual moves, you know, trying to win individual fights. So you had a lot of chaotic rounds where someone would be on the flank, but they themselves would be flanked and players going back and forth. Like, for example, in SK's T side, you know, a player was in window room and they spend 40 seconds trying to figure out where they want to go A and B. You know, just something we're not very used to seeing that from SK.
And it required that individual effort on the first map from Guardian, who, I mean, we talked about. I mean, this is the crazy thing. If you look at these stats that we have on the screen, Simple and Guardian had two very good games. They had a very good series between the two of them. So that's one of those win conditions that we talked about Na'Vi needed to have, and it just doesn't do enough. But you could see, because of those levels, I mean, obviously, with the second map being so quick, the majority of those kills come on a Mirage. And Guardian being a beast with that, with the AWP on that, is what really gave SK trouble. And the only thing that bailed him out of it was the fact that Fur was just a monster.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of Guardian fans had a big sigh of relief when they saw some of those flicks landing, right, Duncan? It was a little bit of a reminder of what he is capable of with that AWP.
Yeah, and the interesting detail, actually, this is one of the reasons why I actually felt like Na'Vi had a shot on Mirage, is that when SK was on CT side, obviously they really struggled in the first half. For some weird reason, this is like the one map where Fallen, probably still the best AWPer we have, someone neutralizes himself, you know. I mean, he actually plays the same spots as Guardian does, but the difference is Guardian really got it going. You see so many highlights when he plays around that ticket booth. Fallen seems kind of like he takes those spots, but he just doesn't win the duels for some reason.
I mean, Samur made a good point during the cast. It's very difficult for AWPers to have impact on Mirage because they usually play mid, right? That's the long range. That's where you have a lot of action early on. But the T's are spending so many resources, so much utility early on to deny vision, that smoke top mid, and the window room smoke, then the deep connector smoke, right? Where do you go? You see Guardian a lot of times jump out of window room and then take damage running back through connector through the Molotov, right? So they always go back to that ticket booth to defend a late A split, but you know, then you get flash, you can get smoked off there as well. It's much more difficult than some of the other maps to be impactful on the AWP.
I'm glad you mentioned Fur, because we haven't got a chance to actually check in with them. Two Brazilians are standing by with Parler, and quite the antithesis of Brazilians, I like to call them, it's Furry Taco.
Hey guys, I'm here with Taco and Fur. These guys have... Sorry guys, there's a bit of confusion about whether I was live or not, but we are definitely live. I can hear myself in the stadium, sorry about that. I'm here with Taco and Fur. Guys, congratulations on that victory over Na'Vi.
Thank you, Pala. It's a pleasure to be here with my teammate and with you. So it was a really good game for us. I'm really happy right now.
Yeah, and so Fur does have great English, but he feels more comfortable in the interview speaking Portuguese. And so would you like to give your initial thoughts, Fur, please, on that matchup?
Quais seus pensamentos sobre essa partida?
Cara, eu acho que a gente treinou bastante, a gente não teve muito tempo, mas eu estou muito feliz pelo que a gente está fazendo com o novo jogador. E a gente tem muito para provar ainda, não só para nós, como para todo mundo. A gente vai fazer isso, a gente veio aqui para ganhar.
Yeah, first said that I don't even remember what he said, but
but
he said we are here to win. Everything worked out today, and we are here to win.
And I asked, because I know Smix was going to speak to Fallen, you are pretty confident in your English speaking on camera. I definitely wanted to get him involved as well, because he had an amazing series. Fur, why did you play so well? What happened?
Eu queria envolver você porque queria mesmo que você não tenha tanta confiança no inglês, eu queria envolver você porque você tem uma série espetacular. Como que você jogou tão bem?
Cara, eu acredito que assim, a gente treina bastante e eu acho que cada um aparece na hora que precisa. Então, eu fiz uma série boa porque precisou bastante de mim, então eu tava ali quando precisaram. E assim como todo mundo dos meus times aparecem, eu acho que a gente tá jogando muito bem como um time. E como você joga muito bem como um time, às vezes aparece uma pessoa aí que dá uma brilhada a mais, mas nada demais.
I think it's teamwork. We practice really hard, and everybody in the team show up when it's needed. And today was me. It works when you have a real team. So today was me, and maybe tomorrow can be my teammates.
How has the addition of Phelps been for you guys? I know Fallen has said that it's working pretty well. And so, what do you guys think?
Phelps is a really great player. Like, maybe he's gifted, I don't know, but he's really smart. It's really easy to make him understand how our system works, because we are together for like almost 2 years, me, Fur, Cold, and Fallen, and he's doing really well already, but I think he has the potential to do much more. He played amazing this series as well. He's a really good player, and I think everybody in the team is happy to play with him.
All right, I will leave the final words with Fur, who I think is one of the standouts of that last series. Fur, you guys have, arguably last year, were the best team in the world for the main period of that year. And then you had a bit of a dip, and now it seems that you guys are really starting to find some great consistency again, even though you did have some pretty good results in that meantime. How does it feel to be making the semi-final here at DreamHack Las Vegas?
Bom, cara, eu tô muito feliz. A gente veio treinando pouco, só que a gente sabe do nosso potencial. O Phelps, ele encaixou como uma luva no nosso time. E eu tô muito feliz, muito orgulhoso do que a gente fez aqui. E a gente tem muito mais pra fazer. Então, a semifinal é um pouco do que a gente tá esperando pra esse campeonato da DreamHack.
Semifinals is just make the semifinals is just a little thing that we can do in this tournament. Phelps fits really fine and really well in our team. I'm really proud of my team and I'm really happy that we have the chance to win the tournament.
All right, well, tomorrow, guys, you will be playing off against North, the Danish squad. And so best of luck in that. And so you can help now and have some rest. For now, we will head back to Alex and the guys on the desk.
Parla there with Fur and Taco. It's wise to get him in on the interview, because the point we were making prior to that was that he did have a performance that kind of justifies the God attached to his name, right? Fur God, he's been known for oh so long back in the day as well, but this was one of those performances, Jason, that I think both he and his fans will remember.
Yeah, and it's actually very cool to see him playing this well for a stretch, because I think a lot of people who have just kind of come into Counter-Strike in the past year or so didn't see the version of Luminosity as in, when they were rising up in the ranks, when they were, first kind of got noticed at MLGX games, sure. When Fur was supposed to be like that hard carry, he was the star of the team. They didn't see him leading the way for the squad, and it's just a testament to how much he gives up for Cold and into the system, because he is kind of that second player now. Cold is the very consistent one, so this is what we've always said, that Fur has this potential in him. He has this skill and this talent, and now he's starting to show it off to people.
Absolutely. And talking of showing off to people, Yanko, I think you've got something for us.
you mean the better man, okay.
Yes, please.
Yes,
naked
Alex.
News.
Well, naked news.
You also, you heard Fallen say in the interview about their game tomorrow versus North, right, that it's going to come down to who can adjust faster, who can adjust better. So one of the rounds in regulation from Mirage, actually, where you can see how they were able to adjust on the fly, and it's a crucial round because, as you can see, SK decides to force buy with a lot of Tech Nines, and they do the same thing, top mid smoke, also the window smoke. You can see how Guardian is, his vision is denied, simple conscient, I mean, he throw his own smoke, and Adder is pushing towards Cat, and this is something that Na'Vi did a lot, actually, in this half. They had Edward always pushing towards Cat, they were always aggressive, fighting towards the middle area of the map, leaving C's sometimes alone towards B. So you can see how SK basically just wants to draw the same reaction, but they have the brunt of the players who are just going to explode towards the site and have Phelps try to sneak through the smoke on mid, try to get a cheeky kill, which is something that he's actually extremely good at, playing around the smoke, similar to Snacks, for example. You can see how that's coming. Edward doesn't expect him at all, and they just have really, really good timing at going for that split towards the B bomb site. You can see the score is 13-12. If SK loses this round, they're forced to eco. Navi probably gets 15, and more likely than not, they close up the game right then and there. So a great move, even with limited utility, limited weapons. SK makes a great call. They execute it properly and win the all-important round, which in the end got them into overtime.
And that overtime, I mean, that must have been such an exhausting process. I mean, you can attest to it, right? I mean, Jason, when you were playing and those overtimes came in, it's just when it finally, when GG is called, even if you've, I mean, even if you've won, it's still just that it's taken a lot out of you as you look ahead to potentially two more maps.
Yeah, it's the mentality as well. It's the draining, obviously,
and losing,
it's having to and be focused. Well, I mean, that's the interesting. That's the big point of going into the next map train. And Yanko brought it up. Columbus was exactly the same. Very close first map, mentally drained. Go into the second, you win the pistol. Great, you get on the start on the right foot, and then you get eco'd in the second round right after that. So, you know, that's just the kind of things that'll just flat out crush you. I think it's interesting to note as well. I mean, it should be mentioned the overtime rules, having 16K and MR3 of overtime, which most tournaments that we're seeing have MR3 10K still. So I know that's been a conversation among the community a couple different times, you know, recently.
We could have it for an hour, but we'll just acknowledge that's how it is. Let's not do that. Duncan, your closing thoughts on the series, seeing Na'Vi eliminated from the tournament, not making it to the semis.
I think it's reasonable. I think it's what you should have expected. You know, they did well enough to get to this point in time. They showed it. What's good is they have righted the ship in terms of they're not the team that was going out in the group stage of tournaments and was just failing flat out to even get to best of three series. They're clearly like a top 10 team. The problem is, I mean, what kind of opponent can they actually really beat to go deep in a tournament at this point in time? Because it feels like if they're playing, you know, the Astralis, the SK, they will probably Virtus Pro. It's going to be a tough order for them to get the two maps out of the three. So we saw in this one here, they even had the stars turn up, and even then it still didn't really happen for them. So, yeah, it feels like things are gradually going in the right direction, just maybe too late in as much as now we've got all these good teams at the top. You know, it's not like that era when Cloud9, Optic, these teams could sneak a tournament, because maybe in those days the firepower could have been enough.
I mean, I'm personally very scared for this Na'Vi lineup. Not just, you know, they lost to SK, there's, you know, nothing wrong about that, but the demeanor of the players, especially on that second map, in the rounds that they were going for, like very individualistic rounds, being over pretty early on, you know, it's not the Na'Vi, you know, right? And you're, what happens if they have another bad run? I mean, this is not a team that's going to be satisfied with getting to the quarterfinals of tournaments, right? If they have another bad showing at Katowice, you wonder if this is where they have, you know, just think that it's beyond fixing and they need to make another roster change. Yeah.
Well, I mean, we can leave it there. Duncan suggesting that at least the Na'Vi stars showed up. And in our semifinals, the stars will show up as well. Of course, to the stars, Astralis are going to be doing their battle versus Virtus Pro in the semifinal of the day. And following that, you get SK North, Battle of the Grey Logos. It is going to be intriguing to see if North really can make this deep run in the tournament. There was a lot of interesting discussion surrounding them at that group stage, and now they're one best of three away from being in the grand finals.
I mean, this is one of the few tournaments where the playoff bracket actually plays out ideally, considering the matchups. So I think tomorrow is going to be super exciting.
I think that's a perfect way to leave it. It will be super exciting. I think a couple of words regarding Astralis VP as well for the people at home. This game is worth coming to see live. Astralis versus Virtus Pro, a rematch of the exact game that filled the entire Fox Theater with cheers and a lot of crazy competitive chanting. I'm sure you guys were there to experience that as well. But Duncan, my eyes were locked here.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Either
just
way, you were in your boxer shorts at home crying.
Okay, you were there too, Alex.
Wow, that was just... What,
he, was let's just say he was in his home in his boxer shorts crying.
Yeah.
What were you up to?
Yeah. Hey, Duncan.
Serbian way.
Hey, buddy.
Alex. All right.
Hey.
I believe it's time to say this one is done and dusted.
You stop it. I was not going to say that.
Literally
I was simply going to...
done and dusted. Yeah.
You can tell that they want to leave. All right, we'll go. We'll leave it there. VP SK, excuse me. VP Astralis is one to look forward to. A rematch of that E-League Major Grand Final. Let's get out of here. We're having a great time, and you guys can too, of course, if you do. Come on over to the MGM Grand Garden Arena for tomorrow. It's masters.dreamhack.com. All right, we're going to disappear. Thank you so much for joining us for another fantastic day here at DreamHack Masters. NIP will no longer have a chance to defend their throne, and therefore someone else will be crowned champion tomorrow. It's been an absolute pleasure. A big shout out to our sponsors, Monster Energy, HyperX, Asus ROG, and the very hotel we stand in, MGM Grand. Thanks for joining us. We'll be back tomorrow with your semis and that grand final. It's going to be loud. It's going to be awesome, and we hope to see you there.